So we have our site. Is it ready to share with Rebecca? Sure, but each client project varies regarding when you're comfortable sending the work to the client. So what we'll do in this video is a pre-publish checklist. And publishing is split up into two phases. We're publishing a staging domain, which we can share with Hayes Valley to get feedback. And we're publishing the actual site a little bit later. So in this, we'll go through each page. Home, portfolio, process, design team, contact, and then we'll publish to our staging domain. Is this going to lead to the perfect site? Of course not, but it's so much better than where they were. And just like checking spelling and grammar, it's a good idea to give this a once-over before sending a draft to Rebecca and her team. So let's start on the homepage, and things look pretty good. One immediate thing to note is now that we've gotten that information back from Rebecca regarding Recaptcha, we'll want to add, underneath this text field, we'll want to add validation. So we can do that by going to project settings. And before in the course, we covered going to forms to add that Recaptcha V2 site key. So with the magic of editing, there they are. We'll go in and save our changes and we'll enable Recaptcha. Now, when you flick this switch on, when we enable Recaptcha, that means once we save and once we enable using this button right here, that means that any forms on the site that don't have a Recaptcha field, that don't have that element that lets people confirm they're human, those forms will fail. Unless they have that element, those forms will fail. So let's make sure when we enable, before we publish, before we move on to anything, those forms need to have the Recaptcha field. Now, if the site was already published and we enabled Recaptcha before we even added those elements, even before we published, those forms would fail to submit. So what we'll do, since we haven't shared it with Rebecca and we haven't shared it with anyone in a wider sense, we're okay taking our time with this, but that's just something to note with Recaptcha validation. Make sure before enabling, before turning on that switch, that everything is set and you have those fields, you have that Recaptcha element added to all forms. So let's do that now. We'll go in to our contact form holder and we'll go down and grab Recaptcha. We'll place it right underneath the message field, and that looks pretty good. Let's add some, first off, let's create a class, Recaptcha. Let's add some lower margin. Let's see how 30 looks. Looks pretty good, even above and below. That looks pretty good. So preview mode, great. Okay, let's check out tablet, mobile landscape. So it starts to get a little wide there. We might want to grab our contact form holder instead of 25. We might just want to go to 0. That looks good. Just holding down Option or Alt on PC and just grabbing and adjusting both sides at once. That's good. Mobile portrait. The Recaptcha field itself is a little tight right there. We could just grab our form and set overflow to hidden. That'll make sure it clips so that if it gets too narrow, it's not going to overflow onto the rest of the page and cause a weird scroll issue. Okay, let's close out of the symbol and go back to desktop. All right. How does everything else look? Well, we're having that consistent look of 15 pixels. We're having that grid with columns and rows spaced at 15 pixels. This looks good. This home hero image, that looks pretty good too. We can always grab that home hero section here and adjust our minimum height. So it depends on what browser, what viewport height, what that size is, but it'll always take up 70%, a minimum of 70% of that height. That looks good at 70. We can always make an adjustment, maybe 75 looks a little better. And we'll scroll down. This looks good. We could grab our collection list wrapper here. And instead of 30, we could do 60 underneath for some added white space. That looks okay. Our process, that might be a little tight. We're just making adjustments here. We're just eyeballing this. We don't have to get too perfectionist about this, but let's try 150. That looks better. Another thing to note, things that are dynamic, like our team member preview here. Let's go into our navigator. Things like this, they'll show 6 team members because we have 6 team members, but if we add a 7th, that 7th team member would show up. The section would get taller, and that could look a little unsightly. What we might want to do is set a limit here. This is a good preventative measure. This isn't something Rebecca will notice right away. This is not something her firm will notice right away, but down the road as they add more team members, this limit will prevent the section from just taking up so much space. So let's set a limit just so we can demonstrate. Let's put 3. So we see 3 right here. And if we click this, we'll see that we have a second row here And that works because there are six, but just in case, let's remove that extra row, just in case they only want to feature three. Now, when we add more team members, another row will automatically generate, but it won't take up space if we go down to three. It'll just be one row. That's pretty good. Let's set it to six. That's it. The rest of our home section looks great. Let's move on down. Tablet. It's looking solid. Mobile landscape. Well, we are getting some crowding here. This might be because it's manually positioned. Let's go back to the style panel. And that's correct. This page preview is manually positioned. So there are a few ways to do this. We could switch its position to auto, and that will override that. That's better. We can also remove some of that padding we just added. So it's just 60 on the top and bottom. That's good. And then we'll want to add what we used before, that same technique. Let's add an overlay, a color overlay. And we'll grab that color from the next section. We'll just use the eyedropper tool, grab that color, drop the opacity slightly. That looks better. Another thing, these buttons are a little close to the paragraph. We could add some space there. In fact, let's go back to desktop. Yeah, they're a little close. So let's add margin on the top. Let's try 15. It's a little better. That's a little more even in terms of distribution, the space between our process, the paragraph, and the button. Looks good on all these sections. Tablet looks good. Mobile landscape, that's where this heading gets a little tight. Let's put this back to 15. That's good. Mobile portrait, yeah, we're looking pretty good here. So another thing to note, this grid, it's evenly spaced. We might want to consider making these secondary buttons full width as well. So let's select the button, and let's set its width to 100%. Then we'll center align that text. That looks a little better. Could also center these, the major heading, but that left alignment works well with the paragraph. That's good. Let's do one final check on desktop. Looking fairly good on desktop. Maybe the nav bar, we could add a little more padding to that nav bar. Let's look at the container, the brand. Yeah, let's go to the nav bar and add some padding on each side. Maybe 10 pixels, just a little extra space there. That looks good there. That looks good there. It gets a little tighter, so we can actually reduce that starting here on the tablet view. I go down, that looks good, that looks good. Okay, fairly consistent here. One final change we might want to try. This big H1, we make homes look beautiful. Let's try that in black. That might be a better look. That's subjective. We can send this to Rebecca, see what she thinks, see what her team thinks. The point is, we've made these considerations on the homepage. Let's move on to the next section. That page is portfolio. Move down to portfolio. This looks pretty good as is. One thing to note, this gray is a little warm. On second look, this looks a little warm. Let's go into that stop, make it a little darker and a little grayer. We're just desaturating by moving to the left here. Still a warm gray. We can increase that contrast a little more. Still a warm gray, but it's a little less brown. That looks good. These sections are looking pretty good. This is looking great on desktop. Let's grab and test. Yeah, this looks excellent. Let's move from desktop down to tablet. Again, we're just eyeballing, checking everything out. Because we made those changes on the homepage for contact form section, they're affecting every other instance. Because we're using a symbol, that change affected every instance of that symbol. Not just in terms of styling, but if we changed the content in one of the symbols, it'll affect all the other symbols as well. So this is looking pretty good. Let's check mobile landscape. Looking good here. Let's check the bottom. Okay, mobile portrait, also looking good. Now, something to note up here, we changed this rich text block to 13, starting on mobile landscape. It was 13, 14 here. This right here is 15. That might work since it's a hero paragraph, since it's in the hero section, but going down here, it might be significantly larger. We might want to try dropping this to 14, dropping this one to 14 is fine. Mobile landscape, the contrast between the text and the background is a little low. So starting with mobile landscape, with our hero section selected, let's affect that gradient. Let's bring that first stop a little farther to the right, and let's even change the angle. So we'll just do this and drop that a little more. So now we have some extra contrast between the background and that text. That looks good on mobile portrait. Oh, so right here, what's happening, our hero section, that featured design, set to cover. Oh, that's part of the image. It looked like it was tiling right there, but that's part of the image. Okay, so that looks okay. Now, the other part of portfolio we have that additional page for client projects. Let's go there. Let's switch to desktop and take a look here. We have each of these beautiful images. That looks great. Spacing's good. We have enough white space here. The rich text is rendering okay. Let's switch to another one. This looks excellent. We have a nice, good amount of space here. Let's go to tablet. Looks good. Mobile landscape. How are we looking on mobile landscape? Again, we did a pretty good job when we set up our responsiveness and fluidity testing earlier. These sections are looking good. Okay, one thing to note in the footer, just realizing this now, but with that limited and mobile portrait, with that limited padding on the sides, this button is taking up quite a bit. So let's grab the footer itself and just add a little bit, maybe 10 pixels on each side, just so the button isn't fully butting up to the edge of the footer. That's looking better. Let's close out of there. Okay, that's portfolio. Let's move on to the next page, our process. We'll go to our process. And this looks pretty good on desktop. Let's try it on a more narrow display. Looks good. Of course, our contact our team form is looking good. We've configured that on other displays. Looking good here. Let's check mobile landscape. Okay, mobile portrait. The process page looks pretty good on all different views. Let's switch to our design team. We'll go to our design team page. Let's go, oh, that's something we're gonna have to fix in a moment, but let's go back here. This looks good. Let's try reflowing, also looks good. Desktop's okay. Let's go to tablet. We're looking fine on tablet. A little extra white space here. Could grab this team member grid, lower that at the bottom to 30, just get the contact, maybe even zero. Yeah, just to get the contact, our team text a little bit closer, limited real estate on tablet. Mobile landscape, also looking good. Mobile portrait, we saw that problem earlier. So we have a link block. We could be using this elsewhere. We are using it on other pages. So let's create team member link. It's a combo class here. And let's set a line to center, just to make sure this looks good on mobile landscape. Okay, that looks good. The white space at the bottom looks good. Okay, the other part of our team members, we have this team members template. Let's go there and we'll try it on desktop. Looking good. We're seeing the recent work for Adina. Let's try another one. Let's switch to Rebecca. Also looking very good here. Let's grab the edge, test fluidity. Okay, let's try tablet. Tablet, the side-by-side looks good. We did a pretty good job setting this up originally. Again, we're just eyeballing it. We're making sure things look good because we made other changes to other pages. It always helps to go back through each of these pages to verify a change to a class on one page didn't affect all the other classes using that on another page. Let's try mobile landscape. Looking solid here. Let's try mobile portrait. Also good. All right. So that's team members. Let's move on to contact. We'll move to the contact us page, back to desktop. Our contact form looks good. We will want to add because we added it to the home page and that was in the symbol and that's on almost every other page. It's not on this page. This is a separate contact form. So we'll go in here and add our Recaptcha validation. And that is right here. We'll drag that right into the form field underneath the message. And we'll add the same class we used before, Recaptcha. We're adding Recaptcha to every form on our site. So, tablet, mobile landscape, scroll up to the top, mobile landscape, mobile portrait. It looks pretty good. Okay, well, that's our five main pages. Now our staging domain. Let's go to publish, and this is going to be hazevalley.webflow.io. We can go in to our project settings and change that. We can go in and make a change. We can call it Haze Valley preview, but this is fine. We can just do Haze Valley for now. That's fine as is. Let's go back to the designer. And this is going to be fairly straightforward. We're not going to have to worry about FTP or exporting our code because we're just going to go to the Publish menu and press Publish to selected domains, like this. That's it. We can just open this in a new tab, and let's break away that tab. Let's pull that out and resize so we can see what this looks like published. This is the published site. This is exactly what Rebecca and her team can see if we send them this URL right here. Go to Portfolio. Go to our process. Go to our design team. Contact us. We can go to Portfolio and preview any of these. Let's go to Industrial Loft Reno. Google thinks this is Latin because there's lorem ipsum. Let's close that out. This looks really good. And in Google, we can test. We can just grab the edge here and see what would happen on different kinds of views. And also in Chrome here, we can inspect. Let's right click, go to inspect. And in DevTools, let's move this over here, we can go and press this button right here. This is the device toolbar. And when we do that, we have this layout that shows up. So we can see what it looks like on different devices. This is a good way to check the published site to see how it looks once it's published. Very similar to how we can do it in preview mode in Webflow, but we'll try it in Chrome just to verify that things look good. Let's go up here, homepage. Looking great. And we can grab that URL, that one right there. We can copy that to our clipboard, and that's it. We're ready to send that link to Rebecca. In the next video, we'll move forward with connecting a custom domain so we can get the actual Hayes Valley interior design site on the web.